talk about spear and shield, how to use properly and actually be effective with it. It's a hard combination to use when you're not in formation. That's a little bit better. When you're in formation, it's awesome. Because I can use this reach to keep people at bay. I can prod at you a little bit while checking my target over there. Like, I want to prod at this guy. I'm threatening you. There it is. Bam! And I attack and come back. This is especially good in formation. Somebody's, if you got a bunch of these and somebody has a bunch of just sword stuff, you can keep them at bay pretty handily. But what happens when you're not in formation? This loses a whole lot of its strengths. The reach is a problem because once they get past the point, not too much you can do besides try to retract and bring the point back. Which if you're sitting back here, it's so easy to just knock this thing aside and come on in. So, if you're going to use this without some friends, you have to grip it near the middle. This. Now, we're not gripping it over arm. As you can see, this is as far as I can extend, where I'm touching this dummy, which is just out of shot. Here, I can barely touch him. I flip around while keeping my hand in the same position. I thrust at him. I know you can't really tell, but I got this much range. From about here up, so more than a foot, just by flipping my grip around. And with this, I can't attack low. So, yeah, you want to grip it like this, thumb forward. Now, how do you fight with this? Well, first let's go over if you're facing another spear and you're on your own. Well, you can grip this further out. You don't want to go too far out because you can just knock it aside. You want to keep it back a little, but not too far. This belt can keep rattling. So, you want to use some of your reach, but not overextend. This works great against somebody using a two-handed spear because you don't have to close near as much as you do if you have a short weapon. If your weapon's like this, you have to get way up here, but with this, I can be back here. Stand right here and then just quick little, and I can get you. It's very nice. I've actually had good luck with it in the bouts that I've done with it. Also be pretty good against a pole axe for the same sort of reason. They're coming and I can cover myself and still give them a good thrust without having to get too close. But the problems happen when they have short weapons. For example, I'm going up against someone with a two-handed sword. If I hold it out here, they're just going to deflect or grab it, and I have to rely on my shield and hope that I have a secondary. But this does have advantages. Again, I've got the reach. If I keep this back, they can't really deflect it. I can prod at a distance that they can't compete with. Sometimes, even getting a good kill in. But generally, just kind of baiting them. And then they charge in. That's where this excels. They charge in, I can cover with my shield, and give a thrust as they come in. Just meet, poke. Oh, you're trying to attack over there? Nope. Trying to attack my head? Nope. Attack low? Nope. That sort of thing. It actually does really, really well against two-handed weapons, all things considered, if you know how to exploit with it. Which, I did a series that nobody really watched, Deadliest Duelist, I think it was called, where I pitted a bunch of different weapons. I had the Aspis and Dory, and I gave it shit. I honestly think, the way I was using it, and that was extended like this. If I would have pitched it as like this, probably would have been a lot better. But I might redo that series sometime. But here's the biggest issue. Shields. Thrusting weapons have problems with shields. Somebody has a sword and shield, I'm in deep shit. I can't really do much to their shield. It's all over here, and they're just going to hack away at my shield and find an exploit and kill me. So I'm outclassed, but I'm not beat. There's ways. Again, you have to keep the point in. And hold it where, again, you've got a little more range than them. Where you can prod and bait them. This is an exploitation weapon. Bait them into swinging, take a small step back. You want to be at the range where they think that they can hit you, If you move back just a little bit, they're going to miss. That's where you want to be. You want to make them swing while you can be, just step right into that range and then boom, exploit the hole that they make. Exploit the gaps. Make them make a mistake, make them give you an opening, and then hit it. You can't wait for the opening to appear and then try to hit it because they're going to cover it up in that time. Like, huh? Oh, there's the hole. Aw. No, it's, okay, you swing it there. Wah. Yeah, you know that it's coming. You have to be receptive. Reactionary. You have to be quick, too. You have to receive. Okay, here's a swing. It's going to be right there. Yeah, gotcha. So you have to be on your mobile, too. If his shield's over here, while prodding over here, not going to do much, I got to come over here and thrust. So you got to find the gaps, exploit them, make them make a mistake, prod. Make them think, ha, now you can come in when you be ready for them. When they do, you just stab into the hole that they give you. And then give them a hole through that hole that they gave you. So that's the gist of using spear and shield. You have to be good at seeing the openings before they arise and getting to them as they arise. You have to keep your point back, keep it ready, and then to move it, it's more on the shoulders. Our thrust here and come back up here. And the shoulder's not really the wrist. The wrist means go forearm and elbow, and not really much better, but the arm itself, pretty quick. And you have to, it's not right, pretty quick. Know how to use your torso. If they're knocking it this way, I can brace it, my elbow and my body here, where it's not going that way. Same thing over here, my elbow back here, and it's not going that way. And I can use that, they knock it this way, I can catapult it around and hit, which is quite handy. It's nice. So, that's just another quick little tidbit. So, use your body, use your eyes, hit the targets as they come, and you watch the rest of the video, you know what all I said. Just follow those steps and you might not die. So easily, at least. You'll still probably lose. I did do okay with it, but yeah, it's not a strong set. But it's fun, damn it, and that's all that counts.